Hello there, guys. Feng here, and welcome to Jack Smith. You're probably wondering what the hell, Feng? What's going on here? I don't normally play flash games. I mean, the only one I've really played that much at all of is Rebuild and The Last Stand. But I found this one the other day, looking at the armor games, and this one's actually a really cool game. Basically, what you got to do is you're a donkey, you're an ass, and you have to basically create weapons to defend the castles and shit like that. It's actually really cool. So we're gonna crack on. I haven't got a game on this particular one yet. So enter your name below, Fangfurf, because why not? I must remember not to use my wheel, otherwise the video will fuck up. Meet Jack Smith. He's a blah blah blah. He enjoyed his job. Story, blah blah blah. Who cares? Right. So, here we go. Why is the sound on? I'll to turn the sound down. Oh well, whatever. Right. Here we go. Here we are. Okay. So there's evil things coming. Indeed. Is that? What's the music like? Oh, it's music. I'm doing that just in case it copyrights. Anyway, you called the local soldiers to your cause. Click to take a weapon order. So, yep, you'll get pigs, evil pigs. I don't know, piggies and lambs and all other sorts of animals, and they'll want an order. As you can see, this one wants a sword, so we need to craft him a sword. So we need to click on this, click a sword, which is the only one we have access to at the moment. We need to click the mold to start creating a long sword. You'll earn molds for other swords as you travel. Okie dokie then. So, now we have a choice. We can select what metal we want. Now, obviously, at the moment, we've only got access to copper. But copper we have an unlimited supply of. Now, as the game goes on, you will get access to other stuff like bronze, iron, steel, with the best one being crystal. So, that's cool. Okay, now what you need to do is you need to try and actually melt the copper. So we need to keep going until fan it down until it gets there, and then we pull. We need to pull it slowly though, because if we go too quick, then it will spill over and it will fuck the mold up. And there we go. Now we need to hammer it down to sharpen the edges up. So we need to make sure that it's fairly even all over. Jesus Christ, Feng, you're absolutely fucking useless at this. It's because I'm not used to doing it on here, that's why. That's my excuse anyway. So I've got one more swing, and that's actually a really crap weapon. Okay, so now we need to build the handle. So we need to try and drop it there like that. There we go, that's perfect. Now we have a grip. Like that. That's good. And then we've got the cap. Now, of course, as you play for the game, you'll get access to new grips and handles and shit like that. And some actually have special properties, which we'll soon find out. We can scrap it if we want to, or we can just click finish, which is what we're going to do. As you can see, there's actually some stats here. So, I think 13 is the amount of damage. That's the amount of health it has before it gets destroyed. And that's how much fire damage it does. Okay, so you can see how well you crafted your sword here. So, as you can see, our forging, not foraging. Forging was great, but that was it. You wait for three soldiers today. Take the soldiers' orders and start another one. Okie dokie then. So let's crack on with this. Okay, let's make another one. So longsword, copper. Pipe it down. Yes, I know. I know how that works. Just go away. Let me warm it up. Better metals will create better weapons, etc., etc. That nearly spilled then. That was lucky. Okay, so we need to hammer it, make sure it's fairly even. I don't think it has to all be even, but obviously the more even it is, the better. As you can see, the great ones are usually a bit more spaced out. Yeah, just about missed that one probably. So let's just make an handle. Make the like that one and that one. There we go. Brilliant. I'm okay with that. And again, that's actually nearly spot on. The ammo was a bit fucked up there, but nonetheless. And we get another sword. So let's do the same here. So copper. It is timed as well, by the way. This is actually the timer Of course, for the first one, it's not normally timed, you know, the time isn't that much to worry about. But as you get further on through the game, then the timer will become a lot more important. So we'll just crack on with this over here, like so. There we go. It's actually pretty much done. There we go. Now we've got to put the handle on. Make it perfect. Perfecto. There we go. Brilliant. And that is nearly a perfect sword. Time is money. If you complete the day's weapons quickly, then any time money will actually be added to your bonus and gems. Okay, so soldiers will actually go over and start using your weapons to kill the things with. Now, you need to hover your mouse over any items it drops to pick them up. There we go. As you can see, I'm absolutely superb at doing that. Hey, and we got loads of bonus loot. Excellent. You can see at the bottom left that our health of our swords, and also the health of the enemy, and how many enemies there actually are. So this last one is usually a boss, and they will drop a shitload of stuff if you can kill it. Now you might be thinking, what's all these holes here for? Well, I'll explain that a bit later. But those are special abilities that you'll get. Okay, so we've actually managed to kill the boss. We got a load of loot for me, and we get this as well, which gives us even more loot and sometimes even weapon recipes, which is really cool. And we get achievements, because everyone loves achievements. And yes, there is XP in the game. You have to level up and stuff. But as you can see, we've got quite a lot of stuff there, so that's nice. Okie dokie, so now we can make a new weapon, which is a simple bow. Indeed. Okie dokie, so the cart carries on and then stops there. I'm assuming that's the progress bar, but hey, who knows. Yes, we know, stuff's coming. Okay, I'll get to crafting. Okay. So, you want a bow. Okay, then we'll make a bow. Bows are a little bit more difficult to craft than that. So, we can press D to view the designs. And as you can see, we've actually got a design for the bow, which we picked up earlier on. Now, we actually have all of the parts, except for the iron simple bow. Actually, yeah, the iron. We haven't actually got no iron. But we can always bookmark the parts, so if you press that, then what will happen is the parts will actually highlight in a star. So as you can see that they're used for a certain bow. Now if you manage to make the bow with all these ingredients, then you'll actually get a bonus. So as you can see, the bonus that to all soldiers. I'm pretty sure that's damage. We can very quickly check. Fang, you idiot! Just pretend that didn't happen. Right, let me carry on. I'm just trying to find what the bonus. Yeah, bonus effects. No, that's not it. I'm after normal effects. Elements. Element chart. Here we go. So that's power. That's the weapon's attack strength. I was right then. See? Nah. Okay, back to game. Right, let's make a bow then. So we can use bronze if we wanted to. That might be useful. Bronze will be a lot better. You can actually multitask in the game. I'm absolutely terrible at multitasking, so I'm not going to bother. But you might need to do it at later levels, so just bear that in mind. And of course, every metal has a different boiling point as well. Well, when I say boiling point, I mean melting point. So, yeah. Now we need to drag both arms of the bow upwards to stretch the strings. You need to make it as balanced as possible, which can be quite difficult. There we go, that there. And try and make it straight as possible. That might not necessarily be straight, but it's fine. So let's just stick one of those on, like so. Unlimited supply of those ones and limited supply of these ones. And there's the arrowhead. And the fletching. There we go. Yay, a bow! It's probably not the best of bows, but it's a bow nonetheless. Hey, actually the stretching wasn't that bad. I was actually expecting it to be a lot worse than it was. Okay, let's make another bow. Right, and again, let's just use copper now since we've got no bronze. Let's stoke up the fire. There we go. Pull it down. Try and get a time bonus if we can. Stretch that to about there, and then stretch that to about. God, that's even worse. Okay, let me just stretch up there, and then I'm trying to keep it as even as possible. That's not even. Fuck it. Just screw it. It's not even, but screw it. I'm actually going to stick these on there like that. Even though I probably shouldn't. It'll give it more stats though. As you can see, this one actually gave it more health, and it'll tell you here anyway. So as you can see, a lot more health, a lot more power, and it's even got frost damage. There we go. It's not the best crafty weapon, but it's decent. And another bow, which makes sense. I probably should have used the bronze really on the with the special ones, but it's fine. It's fine. As long as it's fairly well crafted, it doesn't really matter. Obviously, later levels you'll need to make it out of better metals, but for the most part, it's fine. There we go. Let's stretch that. Stretch that. Stretch that. Oh, that's like that. And then. There we go. That's actually near perfect. I'm a bit happy with that. There we go. Let's plonk that in the middle ish like that. And in the middle ish like that. There we go. Kind of. That'll do. That should be plenty more. There we go. That's actually near perfect. Cracking. And we've got bonus gems. Yay. You do use gems a bit later. A shop will open and you can actually buy certain stuff like materials. Okay, so as you can see, we are shooting at a sluggy kind of thing. A new enemy. Oh no. Pick up all the stuff. Oh look, it's a plant thing that bites. Now every time the enemy attacks, it actually damages your weapon rather than obviously the unit's health, which is kind of weird, but it works. So there we go. We could be in a bit of trouble here now though, because we might not have all three bowmen for the final boss. Oh, we will. But one of them will definitely die pretty much straight away. Well, not die, but they'll run away. Once the weapon's destroyed, they'll just run off like scaredy cats. See? There we go. Now we should be able to do this. Come on. Come on, Feng. Come on. Come on. Yay! We did it! More bonus loot! Brilliant. Lots more bonus loots. What have I got nice? Did I get anything nice from that? Have I leveled up? Yes! I have leveled up. Brilliant. 7 XP to next level. Okie dokie. And we've now unlocked an ability, the cannonball, which is pretty cool. Okie dokie, let's skip that. And here's the shopkeeper. So, I've got some items in stock if you need to buy anything. Yeah, okay, whatever. Let's offer over and see what we can buy. Now, you can actually buy stuff like arrows, grips, and shit like that. But you can also buy the ores, which is useful. I'm going to make it out of all bronze, so I'm actually going to purchase one lot of bronze this time around. Okay, so we have an order for a bow. Let's make it out of bronze. I'm not going to make it out of iron. Let's stalk it up. Come on, you bastard, stalk up. There we go. Pull the string. Oh dear, I spilt it. That was a bit silly of me. There we go. That's perfect. And we're just going to stick normal stuff on here. I want to keep all the special ones till a bit later, especially once we've unlocked a few more recipes. Which we should really look at, really. I didn't actually look at the other recipe. But at least it's got a decent health. It's actually 100% on all everything. Wow. And then we've got a sword. So let's see what we can do with this. I might make this one out of iron. There we go. I'm at sword out of iron. It does need a bit more of a stoke though. So let's get it going. There we go. Pour the liquid, the lovely liquidy substance, into the pan. And we've got to take a few swings at it. Like so. Actually cock that one up a little bit. Should still be alright. If we've got any more swings left, I'll just cover those up. Like so. One and two. There we go. Near perfect. You can use the loot you collected. You have a limited supply. I do want to press D and just have a look at the recipes. I have got a short sword. Oh, you need steel for that. That's a bastard, isn't it, that? Oh well, never mind. Just go back to game. We'll just use the normal stuff for this. So that there, that there, and I've got an awesome on that one. Awesome, dude. Alright. There we go. And apparently my handle was still crap. Okay, that's great. One more sword. Let's make it out of bronze. Let's stoke it up. Stoke, 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 stoke. Come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Pull. Pull on Zircor. That was crap. That was absolutely dreadful. And you'll... Oh, wait, I actually didn't realise it was dreadful. That's good. Sometimes it can be so terrible that it will actually show on this particular screen that you made a fucking cock up of it. But it looks okay. So that's good. There we go. And we'll make this like that. Like that. Awesome again. And like that. Brilliant. Now let's see how this goes. And not as much time, but at least we've got a bit more bonus with that. So that's not a bad idea. Okay, so now we can press 1 to help out. So that's what I'm going to do. There we go. But it just takes time to recharge, so you have to bear that in mind. So I'm going to use it again. Just to finish it off. There we go. Definitely a good idea. Since it will... Oh crap, I nearly missed that then. Since it will take a huge chunk of the HP. Now I'm going to leave this one for the next one. There we go. Land it on the bat. There we go. There's a very good chance we'll have this one in the bag as well. I'll pay it with the bat. There we go. Excellent. Remembering to pick up all the loot. And now to spider. Yay, spiders. I think we might have this one in the bag as well. Yay, excellent, brilliant. But of course, as you get further in, it will become a hell of a lot harder. This is fairly simple, since it's the first few levels. And I believe we're now going to be level 4. Yay! Brilliant. What did we find? A lot of stuff. An awful lot of stuff. New weapon, a double axe. Cool. Okie dokie. Let me just pause that 2 seconds. Okay, that okay then, guys. So that's Jack Smith. A little look at it. It's actually a pretty good game. It's pretty addictive. It being a flash game as well, it's not that bad. It's free to play. So I'll put a link in the description below, and you can go and check it out yourself. Okay then, guys. So I'll see you later.